One of the first things you will do when you start your WordPress site is create pages. Although creating a web page sounds difficult, WordPress has made it easy. Let's get started. There are two ways to add a new page. The first is from the top menu. Click on New next to the plus sign and then choose Page. The other way is to use the left menu. Go to Pages and then add New. Both bring you to the same place. Now, let's go ahead and enter the page title. Enter it in the top bar. We're going to call this page About Us. Before we enter anything else into the page, let's take a quick tour of the menus on the right. Under Publish, you can save a draft, preview, see the status and visibility, or change the publish date. You can also publish or move to trash. Below that is page attributes. Typically, the only page attribute I use is the template. Depending on your theme, there may be different styles of pages offered. For example, the showcase page for your homepage. Next, I have page options. Depending on the theme you are using, this box may have a different title and selections or may not be there at all. Since this box differs on different sites, we're not going to go into details. The middle of the screen is the editor, where you will enter most of the content for the page. You'll see the top two tabs in the right-hand corner of the editor give us a visual or text option. The text tab allows you to edit in HTML. Unless you are familiar with HTML, you don't want to be in the text tab. The visual editor is where I do most of my work. It gives you a lot of the normal editing choices, like bold, italics, strike through, bulleted and numbered lists, quote blocks, left, center or right justify, add links, spell check, and you have the option to edit in full screen mode. The button all the way to the right is called the kitchen sink. The kitchen sink button opens the rest of the editing choices. If you are copying content from an existing website or Word document, you would want to use one of the two clipboard functions here. If you are copying from the web, use the clipboard with the T, and it will put it in as plain text. If you are copying from Word, use the clipboard with the W. We recommend you use this whenever you are copying from the web or Word. Otherwise, you will be importing a lot of undesirable formatting. If you had added content that has formatting you don't want, for example, a different font or background color, you can highlight it and click the eraser to remove the formatting. I've already written the text for this page in Word, so now I'm going to use the paste from Word function to put it in the editor. I just click on the clipboard with the W, paste in my text, and then click on Insert. And here's BusyBot with an SEO tip. Utilize the headings to create a hierarchy of content on the page. That lets search engines like Google know what your titles are. That's a great tip. Let's put it into action. To do this, I'll first highlight the heading, remove the bold that I had used, and then choose which one I want it to be. Now I will do the same for other headings. I'm going to use heading 2 because heading 1 is the title of my page. The way to think about headings 1, 2, 3, and 4 is heading 1 is the page title, heading 2 the section title, heading 3 the subsection title, and so on. Always use the heading instead of bold or underlining to support search engines. You'll be able to learn more about this in the SEO video. Now let's preview our page. It looks great, so I'll publish it. It would look even better with some pictures. We'll cover that in the next video.